A brick smashed into the Jag's side door. He slammed on the brakes and backed the Jag more back and stopped at where the brick had been thrown. The angry driver jumped out of the car. He grabbed the nearest kid and he pushed him up against the car, shouting, "What was that all about? And who are you? Just what the heck do you think you're doing? That's a new car, and you threw a brick, and that's going to cost me a lot of money. Why did you do it?" "Please, mister, please, I'm sorry, but I didn't know what else to do," he pleaded. "I threw the brick because no one else would stop." With tears dripping down his face and off his chin, the youth pointed to a spot just around the parked car. "It's my brother," he said. He rolled off the curb and fell out of his wheelchair, and I can't lift him up. Now sobbing almost beyond control, the boy asked the Sun executive, "Would you please help me to get him back into his wheelchair? He's hurt, and he's too heavy for me." Moved beyond words, the driver tried to swallow the rapidly swelling lump in his throat. He hurriedly lifted the handicapped boy back into the wheelchair. Then he took out a linen handkerchief and he began to dab the fresh scrapes and cuts on the little boy in the wheelchair that he had lifted up. A quick look told him everything was going to be okay. "Thank you, and may God bless you," the grateful child told the stranger. And too shocked for words, the man simply just watched the boy as he pushed the wheelchair down the street toward his house. It was a long, slow walk back to his Jaguar. The damage was noticeable, but the driver never bothered to have the dentist's door repaired. He kept the dent there to remind him of this message. Don't go through life so fast that someone has to throw a brick at you to get your attention. The little boy did something. Do you throw a brick at a new car? Not figuratively, but sometimes you may have to throw a brick at someone to get their attention. God whispers in our souls, and he speaks to our hearts. And sometimes when we don't have time to listen, he will throw a brick at us. It's our choice to listen or not. When desperate times come, when desperate situations occur, what do you do? And in closing, I want to review, just call your attention to those four points. Number one, call upon God for help in desperate times. Number two, assess your situation and weigh your options. Number three, determine to seek the Lord. And number four, count the cost. Think, plan, reason, and execute. And you must know that Psalms 84 and 11 is operative in your lives when you have a committed life unto him that says, "For the Lord God is a sun and shield, and he gives grace and glory. And there is no good thing, no good thing that he will withhold from those that walk uprightly from him, for him." God bless you. Go with God. When you're in a desperate situation, what do you do? Thank you.